Hi, I hope you're well. So I'm going to show you today what I purchased from the 6th year anniversary sale from the Coffee Monsters Co. So I made three orders, don't judge me. So I got three of the freebies and three of the journaling cards. And the whole theme for her anniversary sale this year was Magic Forest or Magical Forest, something like that. And this was the colorway, which isn't normally my thing, but it's really gorgeous. And it's one of those things where you're in a mood to do something different you would use as a theme, if you know what I mean. And it's just stunning. So it has a wee tree and then a wee Modi. Modi are characters, for those of you who don't follow or know Coffee Monsters Co. Her name is Helen. She's a student in Canada and she started a business by herself when she was 15 and it's really successful, and now she's 21. So anyway, our wee characters that she does are called emojis, and this is one peeking out a tree with and a wee emoji on its head, and then an emoji's peeking out of this mushroom house, and it says 0305 because it's March 5th. We actually write our days and months the other way around, so it took me a minute to not be confused by that, but it's because her anniversary sale, our anniversary, was on the 5th of March, and then the sale happened a bit after that. She didn't actually hold it on the day, but she snuck that wee detail in. The freebies are all the same because they're March, and they are now a sticker sheet in her shop that is all about planning. So let me zoom in for this one because it's totally. So you have setup spread, update planner, finish spread, and clean desk, which is hilarious. It's got a post-it stuck to its head and sweating and everything's everywhere, but it's happy, and that's the main thing. And I have three of them. And then as well as getting the free journaling cards, I actually bought some. These at one point were a freebie, but she sells them sometimes in her store. So this one I thought would be perfect for summer. I've been doing a different theme every month in my memory planner, and using an art piece as part of a theme. And this is really good for summer, like I said. So it says sunshine on my mind, and there's an emoji on the beach drinking a lemonade or something, ice drink. It's cute. And then this one is a fairy emoji, and I think it's like an autumn fairy, which is perfect for autumn. But as well as the wee tiny planner freebies, there were other freebies, vinyl stickers and some washi type stickers that are different for her shop. Let me show you. You got different amounts of vinyls depending on what you spent, because I bought three orders. I had one order which was my big main order, and then I went back twice more because I couldn't help myself. So I think I have all of what was on offer. Anyway, there's this vinyl that says, let me just zoom in, sorry. It says couch potato. And then I have three of these little nerdy book loving emojis. And then I have these. Isn't this the truth? I must have at least 13 packages in transit at all times. This is a vinyl I actually got the art piece of, and it's to do with mental health. So it has the happy emoji, and it's obviously like an hourglass because you can easily flip it just like that. And you know, it's a sad emoji, and it's such a really good depiction of mental health. And then this goes with the theme. It's a little fairy, very cute. And this is a little house in the magical forest. And they're all the freebie vinyls. And then you got these. And like I said, these are like, they're washi type stickers that she has never, at least as far as I know, has never done before. And it's like her washies would be, but in sticker form. And I actually own the washi that she sold of this. It's called Floral Forest, and I own it. And this is different versions of it. And you just use that one strip in your planner, even though you don't have a roll of washi. So I thought it was a good idea. So yeah, this is the one that she released in a washi form. It's pink. And then this is the yellow version of it. And then this is like a grey purple, and then a blue, and then a greeny blue. And then this one, this is a neighbourhood collection. So this is the Friendly Neighborhood, which he did release in a washi, which I unfortunately don't own. This is the fall version, autumn. And this is a spring version, this is a summer version, and this is a snowy neighborhood, which I am properly raging that I didn't get. She released it in her advent calendar, and I don't know why I didn't order it. I really don't, and I'm raging that I didn't. Salty much. Hold on, there's another version of her washi like this of neighborhoods, and it's called a spooky neighborhood. Why isn't there? Focus, Mr. Camera. Let me show you. And this is the only one I own. A spooky neighborhood, which is gorgeous. Yeah, and I'd love to own the lot. I'm going to get her Four Seasons one that has the four seasons in one. I thought it'd be really good for like a yearly overview type of a spread, but I'll definitely buy in the autumn, spring, summer, winter versions, and hopefully she re-releases winter because I missed it. Okay, and then this one, she has a thing as well as being the Coffee Monsters Co. where she calls, like they all call themselves like her dad's Papa Tater and Mama Tater and all this here. She just has a thing for potatoes. It's just a thing within the Coffee Monsters Co. community. So she releases little potato stickers, and this is a washi form of it. This then I actually purchased. It wasn't free and I just thought it was cute for spring. It's actually like a really thick cardstock. It's a die cut rather than a vinyl sticker. Right, so I didn't actually buy the bundle itself. I just went a la carte because I didn't want everything in the bundle, and it was good that she offered that option. So let me show you something I got from her shop that I've never bought before that came as part of it. One second. Actually, two of the things that I bought, I've never bought from her before. So the first one is a vellum. It came packaged with this cardstock behind it, and it's really gorgeous. It's got like blue foil, and I figured whenever I'm doing my sticker books, I like to put like vellums in front of things, or just, I don't know, there's endless uses for vellum, to be quite honest. I have it in mind for sticker books, but it's not necessarily what you have to use it for. And this is beautiful, like I said. And if I was using it in a sticker book, this would go in front of spring and be the spring one. And I would get a different vellum, you know, for winter, because I have a section in one of my books for stickers that do with summer, spring, autumn, winter. And I hope you can see that. It's strange, you know, it's hard showing a vellum on camera. And I don't even know if the blue foiling's showing up, but it's gorgeous. And then I got a little charm, which is absolutely adorable. And there was a whole joke within the group. She had wrote a fairy lobster clasp, but she meant like the clasp is a lobster clasp, i.e. it looks like this. This is so tiny. Can you see that? See the way it opens and closes like that? That's a lobster clasp. But people were joking that it was a fairy lobster, as in a lobster that is a fairy. I don't know how to describe it, but it was funny in her Facebook group. Gave me a laugh. Anyway, it's a little planner charm, and I just thought it was really cute. And I have no idea where I want to attach it, because I don't want to wreck it. It's got like silver with the white emoji and a little pink rose and the blue wings. It's a fairy. I'll find somewhere though. It's adorable. Right, let's do the washi next. So, the Magic Forest washi is this one, but she also released one, what did she call it? Let me look it up. In fact, I'll open them up and put them in my book, and I can show you them and tell you the names at the same time. Right, so this one is called Potion Blue, and the way that I had one here, if you can see, that was really tiny emoji heads that went vertically. This one is a more standard version. I think it's 10 millimeter or something. And these ones are 15, I think so. But it has the way I would use the emoji heads for my moods in my memory planner. It's just all the different types of emoji heads. And I actually did a full swatch here. Every one of these, sorry, excuse my
little Westie that I'm dog sitting.
Yeah, every one of these is a different emotion, and it's just really good that there's that many. What's that? 1, 2, 3, 4. 22 different emotions across it. It's really lovely. It's more of a generic one. It's not necessarily a theme, and it has this teal blue in the background. This is the floral washi, by the way, that I was talking about earlier, that she has released. See, it just looks like her washi. That could just be a continuation of that. So it's nice to get to see other ones. I wonder if she's going to release these different colors. Anyway, right. And then this is the other one, which is Magic Forest, in fitting with the theme. And it's funny, if you had told me that it's basically a light cerise pink background with bears and fairies and mushrooms, I'd have thought, maybe I'll sit this one out. But she has an uncanny way of getting me to buy things that I normally wouldn't buy and trying them, because it's just gorgeous. I mean, it's not the sort of thing that I would reach for week in, week out. But it's just one of those things when you're just in that wee bit of a mood for something different, and it's just so stunning. And it has metallic blue little magic sparkles in the background, if you can see them. Yeah, gorgeous. So you get a fairy that has like pointy wings with a flower crown, an emoji inside a tree. The fairy that we got from the die cut that has more rounded wings and a flower in their hair. An emoji on top of a mushroom, and an emoji in a bear onesie, and then the pattern repeats.
So gorgeous.
Right, so next up I have some sticker kits. So this is the Magic Forest one for the Hobonichi cousin. I'll explain the format once, and then after that I'll just talk about the theme and not go through each of the stickers, because it's the same format. So up at the top here there's two event labels, and then this is the full boxes. But the Hobonichi cousin is A5, so it's made, how cute is that? A little full box. And I do think that that's a huge benefit. I don't think it limits you to A5. You can just, hold on.
Yes, you could use these in an 8x10, definitely, and just use more stickers or have a more sparse layout. But
yeah, so you get the 6 full boxes. These are so adorable. And then you get, these are made as, well, they can be space fillers or they can be headers for columns, and they match the theme with a daisy, a mushroom, a crown and a star. Then you get 4 little ickle flag event labels and 4 sticky note style event labels. And then you get to do this week, and they're all to do. And then 2 little ticks for a checklist. And then the second page, you get emoji headers, but it's just the heads, and this will go with anything. It wouldn't necessarily need to be with this theme. A planning emoji, so you can mark your planning for the week. Busy bee, more labels with the theme pattern in the background. Labels with the white, whited out in the middle. These are little labels too here. If you can see that, they're like very small. It finishes there. Then dots, speech bubbles. Her weekend banner is so cute. So you have like the really excited, it's Friday, falling asleep and exhausted, perfectly happy, walking about drinking your coffee, and then stressing out about Monday. That's hilarious. That's the phase of my weekend, exactly. And then a little emoji on a mushroom. And then this is something she includes to use like on your sidebar, and she uses it to track, like a graph to track her work hours. But you can use it for anything. It's a habit tracker graph. This is the Hobonichi cousin kit, and you can get a full Magic Forest mini kit, and this is your normal size that you would get for full boxes. You see the difference, that are made for a 7x9 planner, and it's all the same full boxes but a few extra. So you don't get this one and you don't get this one in the Hobonichi cousin one. But yeah, I didn't buy the full kit for the 7x9. I thought that these would be perfect for a daily, and you could use one a day, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then because there's 8, you could use the full box on the same day that you didn't say you didn't have much on a Saturday, so you could use them together, and then that gives you one a day, something like that. Then this one is Spring Adventures. So this theme is exact same layout, but it's spring, and it's spring adventures, like you're going away somewhere on holiday. So if you had like a little getaway, weekend getaway or something, it would be perfect for it too. And you wouldn't necessarily need to use it in the spring. You could keep out maybe the wee bunny and just use this wee traveling one. And that's the Emoji in an air balloon. But it's really gorgeous. And even though there is pink in this, I don't mind it. It's muted enough that it's okay, and it's not the main colours. I don't mind it once in a while in one kit. I just wouldn't want to use it in every single kit I use every week. You know what I mean? And then again, you have your same planner and Busy Bee and standard that goes with everything. And this is the same here with your boxes, two little, they're not flags, but they're small dual toned, I don't know what they're called, but you can see with your dots and your speech bubbles and your weekend and your graph. But this changes with every Hobonichi Cousin kit. So for example, this one that had the mushroom there, with this one they have the flowers. And then they're the full boxes that go with it. I have, you'll see in a second, other things that go with the kit that I'm going to keep all together, but I'll get to them in a second. So yeah, this is your full boxes of all the same, and then your extras here that you don't get in your Hobonichi Cousin is your A Fresh Start, and what else? That one, Today, Plan, Chores, Nap. Very good. Gorgeous little kit. This one is Self-Care. How cute is this emoji singing in the bath? Just amazing. And it's all the little things you do for self-care. There's coffee and a pencil and a book and making art, all that. And I love all the different colours, particularly the purple. This box is my favourite, I think. And then this is your other box, and the different sticker in this one is the bunny. That must be for like bunny slippers, because it's self-care, I think so. And I don't actually have the full boxes for the self-care. I'll have to get them. And this one is a gloomy week. So you have Eeyore and Sai, the wee sleeping emoji. Just one of those weeks. You can either use it as a gloomy week in your mood, or a gloomy week because it's miserable weather, or just a hard week at work or whatever. Stuff like that, unfortunately, is needed in life. And this just will maybe brighten up that little gloomy week with Ellen's art, because it's just so cute. And I love all the different shades of grey here. And then the different sticker here is a plant. And then the full boxes for these I actually bought previously, so I'm going to actually put them together with this. And this is what they look like. It wasn't in this order. I had got them and already owned them. And that's what they are like there. And then this is a new chapter. And I think this might be my favourite kit. It's just so cute. This little emoji reading a book, and the stack of books, and the wee cat on the shelf, and just gorgeous. And the colours, the blues and the browns together, it's just perfect. And then the changed sticker here is a plant. And then, like with the gloomy working week, I had previously bought these full boxes, and this is what they're here. Nerdy time, just so cute. I think that's my favourite though, that one. And then this is a Golden New Year. I actually had the Golden New Year doodles that I used in my memory planner for the first week in 2022. And this is the kit that goes with it. And it's just so gorgeous. She's really good at colour combinations. Like I showed you earlier, like making things that normally, if I heard a washi had a cerise pink background, she just has a way of making things look good. Definitely. And then this has a little party cupcake with an emoji beside it. And for this one as well, I previously had the full boxes, and that's them here. And I love the fact that it doesn't actually say a year. So, I mean, obviously I haven't used it for 2022, but that doesn't matter. And that is all the kits. I'll have to find a little album to store these in so they're protected until I'm ready to use them. Right, the last thing, but brace yourself, is this big pile of stickers. Pause it, go grab a coffee and come back, and then we'll get stuck in.
So this first sheet is more of the headers, but they can be used as a little space filler or as a header in a vertical box or whatever. And I actually had a freebie that had these, one for each. So this is spring, summer, autumn, winter. Not that I do every week based on seasons, but whenever it, for example, when it, the week in your planner where spring changes to summer, summer changes to winter, winter changes, blah, blah, blah. I like marking that with stickers that are really seasonal, and these are perfect for that. And for me, they're more of a space filler than a header. Know that when you just get that wee bit of awkward space that just doesn't look right and you've nothing else to put in it, these are perfect for that. So they're seasonal Hobonichi cousin headers. So they're not sized for a 7x9 vertical box. They're sized for A5. Just note that in case you go to buy them and think, gosh, these are too small. They're aimed at the Hobonichi cousin. So these are spring with flowers, autumn with a glove and pumpkins, winter with mountains and forests, and summer with watermelons and ice cream and pineapples.
Very cute.
So like I was talking about earlier, you can get particular things that go with her kits. So she has a set of washi strips that have emoji heads in all the different colours that match the kits. These are the sticky notes, and in a second I'll show you she also does doodles that match the kits. And I figured I would get some. So this is the Golden New Year ones from the New Year kit that you saw just a second ago, and has grey, and then it fades to like a yellow down into brown, and just flowers and stars and sparkly New Year type things. Although in saying that, it doesn't scream New Year either. You could use it anytime. Like just because there's stars and moons and whatever, that could be like a galaxy theme, a night theme. That one could be used in spring. That one, the confetti one, could be used for a birthday. So there's lots of use. And then these are the ones from the anniversary sale, the Magic Forest ones. That one's cute with the wood grain. And then this is Spring Adventures with the little traveling emoji in the spring. And I do want to make sure I collect this particular sticker sheet for every kit that I own. So I'm going to actually sit after this and make myself a little list. For example, I'm missing the full boxes from the self-care kit. I'll have to write that down. What do I need to get the sticky notes in, etc. So these ones I thought were cute for spring. It's the flower emojis, and quite a lot of these are spring ones because I have hardly any spring stickers. And it's spring and I want to use them. But anyway, yeah, so the flower emoji sampler large. It's just gorgeous. And then jumping to a different season, these are for winter. And I just thought they were really cute. They're called Funky Snowmen. Look at that wee one. It's just little doodles. Oh my word, that one's my favorite. The wee snowman with a backwards cap. They're just so cute. And they're just little things to add something extra to your planner. Very cute. Then these are overwhelmed, a pun. I have tired turtle and pooped pigeon. She does other ones, like she does one called night owl, I think. And she just like does a pun, and I think this is hilarious. Overwhelmed, and I love the colors in it. Then, in addition to being able to get the sticky notes as I was mentioning, and like doodles, I actually forgot about these. These are doodle headers. So the way you get these for space fillers in the bottom of your kits, you can buy extra sheets of them, and that way you have plenty of space fillers. So these are the ones for Gloomy Week. This one, I don't own the kit, so it's Happy Meal. It's all about planning. And then Hobbies, I don't even know if there is a kit for that one. But, you know, even though these don't have kits to match them, they're space fillers. And when I'm not using a kit, I can still use space fillers. They're handy. But then this is the book one, the new chapter, but it's called Bookish. And then we have Party Time emojis, for obvious reasons, for birthdays. And that one is just so over the top happy. And even just celebrations in life, it's good to have a way to market. I use the Erin Condren Let's Party sticker sheet a lot, and the cakes and stuff in the back of the planner, like the flora
design, but it's nice to have a different way to mark stuff, and it's just, they're really cute. I'll go over the format for anyone who doesn't know, and I'll not do it every time. This is her newer format that I really prefer. So you get four larger emojis at the top, and then you get one row of each of these four smaller. So we have one blowing the little, not party popper, what are they called? Party thing that expands. I don't know the name of it. It's there. You can see it. Throwing confetti, holding a balloon, and just laughing and being happy. Then I thought this was really cute because I bake a lot, and whenever I'm marking baking, again, it's nice to have different ways to mark things. And these are called kitchen scenery emoji, and it's an emoji standing at their kitchen baking and cooking. Then these are my spring TV emojis, and I use these every month in my memory planner for my little currently watching section, but you could also use it just that night in your planner to say you're watching a particular film as well. Definitely. And I have the Christmas version of these and the winter version, and she didn't until recently have a spring version, so the one for my March is now blank and I'll be able to fill this in. These are adorable. So you get a meadow, tulips, wee rabbit onesie with a carrot, flowers, and that wee spotty pillow's dead cute. This is like a forest style one. This one I'll probably use in April. How cute, with the umbrella. Rainbows and more flowers. So I now have the spring TV emojis. And of course I had to get two. No explanation needed, I just had to. So these are spring mug doodles, and I have the winter version of these, but for spring it's a bunny, a mug with flowers on it, a carry out mug with the ring part that keeps your hand from holding the hot cup is a frog and a duck, then a mug that has the sunrise, and a like a China style mug with flowers. And I got two of them. Okay, then we have spring outfits emojis. And honestly, there's no set thing that you would need to use this for. You could, if you get dressed up to go out for dinner, if you just want to look how smug this one looks, if you just want to write something that you achieved and put that beside it, anything. These types of emojis are just fun to have for the little something. So for this one, it is like a summery blouse and trousers. And then the wee dress with the smug look, another wee dress laughing, and another wee smug look, but this is like a jacket. And they're just like so happy it's spring, and I totally feel them. And then spring allergies. So the crying with all the flowers swirling around the head. This one's just totally over it, lying on the floor with a box of hankies, blowing the nose, and then all the redness around it as it sneezes. So that's spring allergies. And then spring cleaning. So we have the little spray bottle, junk pile for whenever you're decluttering, folding clothes, and lighting a little candle. And isn't that part of the fun of the spring cleaning, when you get to like turn your oil burner on or light a candle and your room's all clean, and it's just lovely. And I got two of them. This one is cute. It's rainy day emojis, for a rainy day. No, you can use it for whatever you want, but this one, it's raining and they're smiling, and this one's dancing in the rain, it looks like, with the umbrella down. No, this one's dancing in the rain in a puddle, and they've took their wellies off and just danced. That's hilarious. And then this is the same as that, but on the up, you know, like an opposite flipped direction. That's so cute. And I got two of them. Spring emoji. This one's having a nice drink. This is like a little fairy. This is the one out the garden, and this one is spring shopping, and I got two of those. Then spring planning time, really cute, to mark planning time. So this one's got washi, this one's in the planner with stickers, this one's got a big giant pen, and this one's holding their planner, and like there's like a wee tree growing out of its head. And I got that twice. Then spring working critters. So with this one you get a duck, a rabbit, a frog, and a sheep. Need a drink, hold on. And I got two of them. Right, this one is a new one that she has. It's Reading Bucket List. And they're really funny. So it's book haul, new book, for when you start a new book, cliffhanger, and it's the book's on the cliff and it's hanging off the edge of the cliff. This one is so funny. I could use this for films as well. It's like really annoyed and it's like, are you serious? Like when you just see that thing that you don't understand the plot. But anyway, finished book, did not finish. Crying, holding the book, and then reread, and then the repeat. So they're really hilarious. This I got in a freebie and just really laughed at it and thought it was funny. It says existential crisis. The last time I used it was when I tried to pick my planner for 2022 because it took me so long. And then this one is the 6 year anniversary sample. So all her best sellers of the 6th year of her shop, she put into one sticker sheet. So this is the plain version of that working emoji, but it's the nerdy. So there's one that she had initially that's holding a cup of coffee. Then this is one that I actually just bought recently with the glasses. And that's it there. Then organize for organizing stickers. It's a sleepy emoji, rushing about food for takeaway. That's hilarious. I never saw that. I have the car emojis, but I never saw one where it was like rolling its eyes. That would have been perfect for having to leave our car in to get fixed. I'll have to have a look for them. This is painting, mindful, buying from Amazon, coffee, tea. That looks like a lotus biscuit. I kid. Anxiety, I think that is. Holding a book, love. Working in bed or editing your video in bed or whatever it could be. Face desk. Is that like a lecture or listening to a graph? It'd be good for a work meeting. Music note. Yawn. Need to buy them. Wrapping a present. Popcorn. I'm okay, I guess. The mask on. Going about the shops. Planning. And not swatting a fly. That's so cute. Look at their face. Oh, dear. Oh, whoops, creeping up. This one, whenever I dog sit my mum and dad's dog, Bonnie, or whenever I walk Cody, I have a little paw sticker from Franny Lamb Stickers, but it's actually the only way that I'm able to mark that. So, you know, I like, not there's anything wrong with those stickers, but I like variety. I like marking them different ways. So I got these. They are walk the dog emojis. So these stickers for dogs come in a sampler sheet. The way this is a sampler sheet and has lots of different things, but you can also pick specific things off that sheet and get it as a set. So there's like a scoop the poop one, and there might be a vet one, I can't remember all the different things you need to do for a dog. But because I've taken to marking in my planner when I walk the dog, I thought I would get the walk the dog one specifically. So it's just the same thing, the walking the dog with a really happy face, but different colors of a dog. And like I said, I wanted to make sure I had plenty of them, so I got two. This was wishful thinking. It's a stationary bike emoji, and I would really love to buy a Peloton. It's just something that's in my head. I actually, whenever I join gyms, most of the time I just go to spin class and my husband goes and uses the weights. So for me, it's something I find fun, but being able to do it in your own home really appeals to me, which says it all about me, but sure. And I just think it would be so much fun, and the classes look fun, but I just don't have the money at the minute. And I might just be tempted enough to say that my house can wait and put my health first and get one. But we'll see. I bought the stationary bike emojis anyway in preparation, and I got two of them. No, I didn't. I got three of them. Anyway, this one is Mushroom Forest. Again, I just thought it was cute. I'll probably use it in like an autumn type of a spread. So this little teddy bear is behind a sleeping emoji with a mushroom. Another mushroom with tiny emojis around it. A mushroom, an emoji, and a hedgehog and behind mushrooms. And an emoji behind a mushroom. How many times can you say mushroom? This one is Book Nerd. So sitting reading a load of books, behind a load of books, wrapped in a blanket with a candle reading a book, and lying down reading a book. Then these are ones that I want to get that go where they're available with the kits. So this is the large Magic Forest doodles. They're good for the sidebar, good for filling little spaces. and it's just all different types of things that match the little magic forest theme. And I got two. Oh my word, I bought three. Well, there you go, I can use it twice and then keep one with the kit.
And that is my epic coffee Monsters Co. anniversary order. And I hope you enjoyed watching it and spending some time with me. And thank you so much for watching. Take care, and I'll speak to you soon.